There's a difference. Hilario Gallegos was born here 52 years ago. As a child, he worked 12 hours a day shelling maize until his hands bled. His pay, one piece of bread. Even 10 years ago, he was still on 3 pence a day. But now, he calls no one master.
Señora, hija, Katie, Huasquita, Elsa.
His wife, Maria, makes beer in the same house where the families lived for more than 100 years. They're still desperately poor, but no longer degraded.
We worked hard, but we lived in misery. We had to clothe ourselves because the owner never gave us anything. He didn't even send us to school, which is why none of us can read or write. We were beaten up for the slightest mistake. If two of us had a set to, the owner would punish us with a thrashing. If we were granted an audience with the master, we would say to him, "Good morning, father. I would like to talk to you." And the master would answer, "What's all this about? Do you work on my land? Do you live in one of my houses or out in the fields?" When we told him our names, he'd tell us to get out, saying, "I don't need you. I only want workers here, not layabouts." He never ever listened to us. He maltreated and humiliated us.
At the celebration, a speech. "Brothers, this land is ours. It's our gold and our silver. Saturnino Wilka is a legend in this land." The old man offers his audience a peasant gospel which he's been preaching for half a century. Before the revolution, Saturnino was a wanted man on the run for 40 years, a subversive among the people. His message now, after 10 years, the revolution is still to be won. We have our